Last week, I had a very wonderful workshop with most of you. The workshop is about find your own uniqueness. What impressed me the most was a very simple question. Who am I? A question that has confused me for these recent years. After the workshop, I reflected the important experience that I've been through. One simple word describes my condition. Emptiness. In these 20 years, I've lived in other expectations instead of my own expectations. In my parents' eyes, I'm their good son, which meets their expectation, who did a good job in test. In my teacher's eyes, I'm a great student, which helped his or her a lot of classroom office and always did a good job in any academic subjects. In my classmates' eyes, I am a perfect person who seems to have everything that they want to have. Although I have a lot of things, I'm not happy. To meet others' expectation didn't make me feel happy at all. So when I was a senior high school, this day after day, who am I confused me more and more. At that time, I believed the way to solve this problem is to, like others said, to enter a top university, and then the problem will be solved naturally. And I'll experience a very marvelous university life. However, things didn't go smoothly. Before, when I was in senior high school, I considered NTUST a paradise for me. The result is I've ever been to paradise, but I've never been to me. Indeed, in nowadays society, to success seems to have an SOP. That is, to did a good job in test, to enter a great university, after graduating from the university, get a job with a high income, and the rest of your life will be all smooth, and there won't be any problem with it. However, if you observe those who really live a successful life, you will see they live different ways from one to another to achieve their goal. Julian Ling, have you ever heard of her? Julian Ling? Probably some of you have heard of her. If you haven't heard of her, you might have heard of her work. She was a dancer and a choreographer who arranged a dance composition in a whale pattern. She did Cats and Phantom of the Opera. You must have heard of these two operas. But when she was a student, she felt homeless. She had a hard time sitting in the classroom and paying attention to the courses she took. Her teacher considered there's some problem with her and suggested her mother send her to the hospital. Her mother did it. And when she was sent to the hospital, she was asked to sit in a room and the doctor left with some music for her. The doctor and her mother observed her outside the room. And much to their surprise, what Julian was doing was dancing marvelously with the music. The doctor said, "Ma'am, your daughter is a dancer. Send her to the dance school." And Julian recalled she couldn't tell how marvelous it was. In the dance school, there were people who couldn't sit still in the classroom. There were people who had to move to think, who had to move to realize the world. And I think Julian is lucky because in the late early 30s, ADHD was not invented. So there won't be anyone who gets a thing that is called ADHD. If Julian Ling was born in nowadays, she will probably be diagnosed ADHD and took medicine. Still feels hopeless, like most of the students in Taiwan, probably. I'm not telling you that enter a university, get a job with a great income is wrong. That is just a form of life. But there are 7 billion of people living in the world, and if you observe all of them in detail, you will see that all of their lives are different from one to another. And get into a university and have a great job is just one of them. Picasso once said, "All children are born artists." The problem is how to remain an artist and pay grow up. Now I will say, all of us are born uniqueness. The problem is how to remain your own uniqueness as you grow up. As a club president, I especially like one proverb. Great leaders don't set out to be a leader, they set out to make a difference. Now I, as Simon Tao, will say, great people don't set out to be a person, they set out to live their own uniqueness. Did you find your own uniqueness? Even if you find what's most important of all, did you dare to live your own uniqueness? That is, dare to be different. Toastmasters of the evening.